Hey everybody, welcome to Fabulous Friday at the Friendly Real Estate Group. I am Jeff Reagan. I am the owner and the broker of this company. I'd like to welcome you again to my YouTube channel, Living in Tallahassee, Florida. This week, I just wanted to talk about what's going to new construction versus resale homes. I'm going to give you a few experiences and maybe share with you a few things that might get you thinking about which way to go in 2022. So let's get started right now. Hey, thank you and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time here, I really urge you to go ahead and subscribe. Just hit that old subscribe button and ring the bell and it'll notify you every time I do a new video. Each week I try to bring a video relating to Tallahassee, living in Tallahassee, Florida, some of the different things that you might enjoy doing here, as well as understanding the real estate market. This week's video topic, I'm just going to share some experiences with you that I've had in the past few weeks, or month or so, with new construction homes versus resale homes. You know, when it comes to new construction, there's no doubt in my mind that that is the ultimate, isn't it? For all of us to have a new home, brand new, nobody's ever lived in it. Maybe we've even had a chance to choose some of the colors and tile and countertops and things like that. And that is great. And honestly, to be fair with all of you, the new construction homes in the Tallahassee market are great homes. I think in the Tallahassee-Leon County area, they're too expensive, to be honest with you. But we do have some great builders here, and they're producing homes, but not fast enough. Now, I'm going to talk about the new construction first and a few experiences, and then we'll talk about these resale homes. So when you look at new construction homes, some people think, well, hey, I just got to go and look at the model home, and I pick one, and I can move in it. Well, that's not the case. First of all, most of the builders are all way behind in construction, and many are changing their format on how they actually sell new construction homes. Used to be you could go drive into a new subdivision, pick a lot. Oh, I like this lot. This looks like a great place. And then choose the floor plan of your home, and then, you know, they build it, and then 6 months, 8 months later, you move in. Well, that's not so much the case anymore, because let me tell you about my experience I mentioned in last week's video. We went to the project here in Tallahassee. It's called The Canopy. A very nice project. I think they're going to have somewhere close to 1,000 homes, new homes in there. And they really just began building within the last few years or so, just before this COVID outbreak took place. And they have, the builder there is Premier Fine Homes, great builder. Been in Tallahassee for a long time, but they've really changed the format on how they sell homes. I went there with a couple last week on Sunday, and Jeff and Kristen. And we went in there, and the floor plan of the home that we looked at was nice. It's like about 2,200 square feet. The price on the home was like $525,000. Lot sizes are just really small. They're like 0.14 acres. I mean, to me, that's a postage stamp. Houses are really kind of close together. And long story made short, there's a lot of amenities there. We looked at the beautiful pool and the clubhouse and everything that's offered there. But at the end of the day, the only way the builder is actually selling these homes now is they wait until the home is to the point where it has been completely constructed and has drywall on the inside. Now, I mentioned that a little bit last week, but I ask why. Why are you doing that? And I knew the answer, but I just wanted to kind of get the answer from the builder's point of view. And his representative told me that, it's the cost of materials. It's the shortages that we're experiencing. It's the things that are really related to, everyone blames it on the pandemic. And you know, it is really, it's largely due to the pandemic. And so they can't really lock a price down until the house is at that phase where it's been all built and it's got drywall on the inside. Now, maybe they don't have the floor or the paint on the walls or the kitchen counters and or cabinets and countertops and things like that. So at any rate, you know, they will take a reservation. You can put $2,000 down. It's non-refundable. And they'll hold that lot for you until it gets to this point, and then you can actually lock in your price. And we were told very clearly that because of the cost of materials changing, and by the way, I looked at the cost of lumber, the one of the most basic commodities that goes in a new construction home, and it has increased like upwards of 30 to 40% since August of this year of 2021. Just in a span of like 4 months, lumber has increased like 30 to 40%. It was at its high in April of 2021. And this won't maybe make sense to you, and it's not investment advice, but they quoted in the futures market what's called by the board foot. And 1,000 board foot was like $1,600 in April of this year. It was down as low as like $600 in August of this year. And now it's back up in December of 2021, more like about $1,000 per board foot, or per 1,000 foot, excuse me. However they quote it, I just look at the numbers. I look at charts, and it tells me if it's going up, then the cost is increasing, right? Doesn't take a brainiac to figure that out, but as costs, you know, charts go down, prices go lower. Well, the basic commodities in a house just don't seem to be going down at all. So when you talk about the copper, you know, the wiring, the fixtures and things that go on the inside, the prices are continuing to increase, which is why the builders are not locking down prices like they used to. Now, I don't know if that's a trend or a thing just for the canopy project out there in Tallahassee. But I'm going to start talking to some of the other builders and find out if they're doing the same thing. Because I can totally understand it from a business point of view. I'm sure you can too. Because how do you know what the cost of the materials are going to be 6 months from now as I build this house? So that's going to create a little bit of a challenge with new construction in 2022. There's so many variables in the cost of a new house. I can tell you about another experience, though, that was positive in the sense that with Otto and Carolina, hey, Otto and Carolina, we were able to contract for a home, and it was able to lock down on a price, but the home was totally constructed, and it was just about in the drywall phase. In fact, the drywall was stacked all inside the house. They still got to pick a few things as far as the colors of the paint and some of the light fixtures and the, you know, other things, faucets and so forth and so on, hardware for the cabinets, countertops, flooring. So they're happy, and that's great. We were locked down the price, and that's great. But now I see that that's exactly where a lot of these homes are going. So new construction is going to be a challenge in 2022, because think of it from a builder's point of view, the developer. You know, the cost is so unpredictable that it's hard for them to really know what they can do when it comes to pricing that new construction home. So now on the flip side of that would be the resale homes, existing homes that maybe are in really great condition. And so in the same place in the canopy, I looked at what was available for sale there. And there was only, out of all these hundreds of homes, there's only two homes was available for sale on there. And the one that I looked at for the same couple that was looking at the new construction home was priced at a very reasonable price, really. I mean, it was still like an 1,800 square foot home, just over $400,000, about $410,000. So, you know, the home that we were looking at for new construction was closer to 2,100 square feet for $525,000. And then the resale home that was in the same subdivision, same amenities and everything, right, was like $420,000 for an 1,800 square foot. A little bit smaller, true, but that's just an example. Now, looking out into the rest of the market, I could tell you about Natalie and Dave. They were a couple that was looking for a resale home. In fact, he is a carpenter, and he had the desire to do some fixing fixing up on, you know, hey, that's my Southern coming out in me. I might be a Northern boy, but I've been throwing some y'alls out there once in a while, and yes ma'ams and yes sirs, but you know, I'm learning. And so, but they were willing to do some fixing. Dave's a carpenter. And so we found a really nice home. I mean, nice meaning it was well constructed. It was built in the 80s, but it sat on 6 acres. And we contracted that home and closed for $300,000. So see, the prices of new construction materials was already built into the price of that home, right? I mean, it's sitting there. It was built in the 80s, like I said, the early to mid 80s. I can't remember exactly when. But the point I'm trying to make is if you're handy and if you want a home that maybe has some land to it, not these new construction homes with 0.4, 0.14 acres or anything like that, then why not think about resale homes? And if you're not handy, well, it's a lot harder. Everyone wants the house that's all fixed up and ready to move in, right? I get that. But, you know, the home I'm living in, it needed work, quite a bit of work. In fact, I sunk probably $25,000 into my home within the first year moving in, repairing things, getting it updated, getting it brought up. You know, so if we buy the home right, and if you've got some cash to spend, fix it up and then turn it into that beautiful home. Now, I know in my own personal case, my home's appreciated in value upwards of $60,000. In just a 2-year span. So, new construction versus resale. What do you think? You decide. I'm happy to help you any way that you need it as far as homes. And I'm certainly available. You just need to give me a call. Maybe you've been watching my YouTube channel for quite a while and you feel like you know me personally. And I love that when I get a chance to meet people that say that say that to me. And that's great. And so I want to help you. And I want to really urge you to think about timing and think about patience, because 2022 is going to still be a challenging year. We may see mortgage rates increase. We're still going to see home sales on the rise, and builders with these unpredictable costs are probably going to slow down. And so it's going to create a bigger demand. And then when you top it all off, there's more millennials entering the market that want to buy homes. There's more remote workers that are looking to buy homes because they don't have to be next to the office anymore or go into the office. Things haven't changed a whole lot in the past few years since this COVID. So think about it, and I want to help you. So I would be happy to talk with you. Just give me a shout, give me a text or a phone call, and we can talk about what your plan is for 2022. So my name is Jeff Reagan. I'm the owner and broker of the Friendly Real Estate Group. I have a beautiful team with me, some guys that work with me, so we can help you if you have that need, and just feel free to reach out. So thanks for subscribing. If you haven't, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button and subscribe if you have not. And we'll say thanks for now, and we'll see you next week. Again, signing off. This is my unedited version. Just turn the camera on and talk for a few minutes. Thanks. Talk to you later.